Hi everyone, it's me, Darlene. It is time for another Upcycled Fashions video. I'm so excited. And I have the whole day to get this accomplished. I got up early, sadly, because I only slept 4.5 hours and I was up by 10 a.m. That's very early for me, especially when I didn't sleep all night. But I feel pretty good. So we're going forward with this task. I am going to be using one of the first pieces that I got for Peanut Gallery mail that I absolutely fell in love with, and it's because it's paisley print. This came from Ben and or Jason in New York, and it is a wonderful man's shirt with a collar that I absolutely love and a beautiful paisley print. Look at that. It's black and white. It has fancy cuffs. I do believe it's the perfect shirt. I am going to be transforming this men's shirt into a woman's blouse with an unusual twist to it. Not going to tell you much more than that. Probably change my mind from here to there. But I think I'm going with it. This video was inspired by Blueprint DIY. I don't know her at all, but I came across her video, which I will have linked down below and in the comments. I really fell in love with the shirt. I will be doing it a bit differently than she does, but do go check out her video. And like I said, I will have the link below. I guess that's all I want to mention at this point. Thank you again, Ben and Jason, so much for the clothing you sent. And if anybody finds paisley at a thrift store, that's got my name on it. If you want to send anything for the Upcycled Fashions, my address is also down below in the description and in the comments. Let's just go get started. The first thing I have done is just lay the shirt out flat and I buttoned it. Now what I'm going to be doing is cutting straight down. I'm just eyeballing. And whatever I do on this side, I will use the cutoff piece as the pattern for the other side. So I'm just going to start like here and cut up at a very slight angle, like so. Now let's move the shirt over a little bit. I'm going to lay this down as best as I can. And I'm going to cut. Now I'm just going to measure each side to see if they're somewhat even. See, on that seam, that's exactly 5 inches. And on this seam, an eighth of an inch off. I'm not worrying about an eighth of an inch. We need to hem all the way up and down this garment, each side. But the next step, I will be putting pieces together. So I don't want it to be too stiff, so I don't really want to do a double fold because it'll be sewn to another thing that's a double fold. And I would like it to still be flexible and not stiff. So what I'm going to do, since I don't have my serger out yet, I'm going to just do a zigzag all the way up and down each side, and then I will just fold it over once and stitch. Other side. Now I'm going to a straight stitch and I'm just going to fold over once and stitch. Same on the other side. Now I'm going to go press this, make it nice and crisp. In the video I watched, I believe she started with a shirt that was much too big for her. So she was able to make her side panels for her shirt using the side panels that she cut from the shirt. But we don't have enough fabric to do that. So I'm going to use the sleeves. So I'm just going to cut from the underarm straight across. Extra buttons. We don't get rid of that. And let me open this sleeve up at the seam. I'm saving this cuff, so I want a little bit of seam allowance on the cuff. Let me cut the cuff off first. Okay, I'm gonna go press these two pieces. Now I need to decide how long I want the armhole to be and how long I want the side panel to be. I like the armhole to be kind of deep. This will probably be worn over a tank top anyway. Let's see what the initial one was for the shirt. The original armhole was about to here, so about 9 inches. I think that'll be a good place to start, right there. So I'm just going to put a pin at 9 inches on both sides. Doing the same over here. I just went and put this on my dress form, and I do like the length of the armholes. And then I just put a pin where I want the side panel to stop. So I'm just going to now measure between these two pins, 10 inches. So I'm just going to this pin here, and I'm going to put a pin at 10 inches. And same on this side. I'm going to put a pin at 10 inches. And here, putting a pin at 10 inches. Now we need to cut our side panels for this shirt. I am going to do a little bit of figuring out what I want by measuring this. My mannequin upstairs is approximately like a 42 or 43 inch bust. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure here, like at the bottom of the armhole. This is approximately 15 inches across times 2, because we have 15 inches here, we have 15 inches of the backside. So we know we've got 30 inches. Let me get a piece of scrap paper. Now, if my mannequin's bust is 42, obviously I want the shirt to be loose. I'm going to say I'm going to add 6 inches to that. 42 plus 6 is 48. See if I can zoom in a little bit. I want 48 inches. I know I already have 30 inches, so I need to add 18 inches, and that's out of both sides. So I'm going to divide 18 by 2. That's going to give me 9 inches. So that means I have to add a side panel that is 9 inches wide on each side. Let's allow for seam allowances, and to be on the safe side, we're going to add an inch and make it 10. So each panel will be 10 inches wide at the top. Now let's move on over to the hips. I know you're zoomed, but I'm measuring across the hips. I see that I have 16 inches across, so I have 32 inches on the hips. My mannequin's hips are about 44. Let's add 8 inches to that to be generous. So 44 plus 8 is 52. So we want 52. We have 32. We need to add a total of 20 inches. We have 2 sides to work with, so 20 divided by 2 is 10. Let's add a seam allowance, and that's going to be 11. So we want our side panels to be approximately 10 inches on top and 11 inches on the bottom. That could even be flared out a little bit more. Let's be safe and say 12. Always better too big than too small. Doesn't that look like something you can totally understand at a glance? Here's the bottom line. We want side panels that look something like this. We know that they're going to be 10 inches long, and this is going to be 10 inches wide, and this is going to be 12 inches wide. Now I'm going to take my two panels. The first thing I'm going to do is cut the narrow part of this sleeve panel off. We know we want our panel to be 11 inches long, so I'm going to put this on the 11 inch mark, and I'm going to cut off the bottom. Now, we decided that we're going to have it 10 inches across up top and 12 inches across at the bottom. I'm going to fold this. Half of 10 is 5. So I'm going to find my 5 inch, and I'm going to put a notch right here. Half of 12 is 6. So I'm going to find my 6, and I'm going to put a notch right here. Now I'm just going to cut from this notch to this notch, and if you want to do it against the edge of your cutting mat, you can. Now, another thing that I'm going to do is, instead of making the panel of the underarm completely straight, I'm going to try curving it a little bit. I just think that that would fit better. And even if it doesn't, it'll be different. So I'm just going to be at the top here, and I'm going to just make a curve, just a little curve. I am going to do a zigzag around this entire piece on both pieces, and then I will fold once and do a straight stitch on all sides. Doing the same to the other piece. Now I'm going to fold over once, and on a curve that will be easy to just fold over once, I'm going to do the curved edge and then the bottom hem, and then I'll do the two sides. And now I'm going to finish this other piece the same way off camera. I'm seriously thinking I should have made the side panel longer. I don't know. It just looks like it's going to look weird, but we're committed at this point. I mean, I could always add fabric to this if I needed to, but I don't think I'll be doing that. Now what we're going to do is, instead of right sides together, I'm not going to attach it this way. I'm going to attach it like I did the peacock summer vest cover-up thingy. I'm going to be putting the wrong sides together and stitching down, so the seam is going to be on the outside of the garment, and I just think I'm going to like it better that way. Let's get rid of the bottom piece for right now. We already have our pins marked where this is going to go. We want the right sides together, so let me flip this over, and I'm going to pin at this pin right here and at this pin right here. So that's where we need to be, right there. And down here, same thing. Now we're going to go over to the back pins of that same side. And we're going to get this panel. And we're going to put wrong sides together. And I'm going to put that there and pin. And then over to this side and pin. Now let's do the other side. Obviously, the curved part goes at the top because that's going to be, you know, the armpit, which was probably very silly to do. Okay, want right sides together and pin, and down here and pin. Let's get the back side, pin this here, and pin this here. Now we're just going to go to the machine, and I'm going to top stitch between the pins. You guys, this looked absolutely horrible on my mannequin. It did. It's nothing like I imagined. I think it's too big for her, but it is way too small for me, so I can't show it to you on my body. I don't like all this going on here. It makes too much of a big armhole. What I think I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to take this in right here. I know it's hard to explain. I think on both sides I'm going to just top stitch about an inch in, and then on this side too about an inch in. And I'm sorry that I didn't show you what it looked like on the mannequin. I did not bring my camera with me up there. It's so hot up there. I'm so hot right here on the main floor, but it is boiling up there, so I don't want to go back up and put this all on her again to show you the yucky part. So I'm just going to go ahead and try to take an inch on both sides. I have no clue if I'm making it better or worse. I'm going to do it on all four sides, and just to save myself uploading time, I'm going to do it off camera.
I can't believe what a difference that final step I did made to this shirt. I wish I would have been able to show it to you before, but like I said, I came up here without a camera, and now I'm up here with the wrong friggin' glasses on. So it's not my kind of day. Here is what the side looks like now. I did know that there was going to be side boob showing, which is why I thought this would go good on a tank top. Now, before I took this inch, see, this is where I pinched an inch right here, front and back, on both sides. Before I did that, this kind of just wanted to pop out, as opposed to be set in, and it looked horrible. I'm also unsure of the length of the shirt. I think if the shirt was shortened, I don't know. I'm not going to shorten it, because I like the length of it from the front and the back. I love that it's now sleeveless. It looks very girly. And this is the back. I really do love the actual shirt. I'm just not sure I love what I did with it. I just opened it, and it is certainly cute. Opened up, and the sides seem to look better opened. So I do believe it is a cute shirt. It's just something I'm not used to. Again, maybe on someone a little bit smaller in the bust, maybe it would have a whole different look to it. And this is what it looks like in the back when it's open. So I don't know. I'm very in between on this one. I love it from the front. I'm not crazy about it from the side. I could go try it on my other mannequin, but I know it would be way too big for her. She would be swimming in it, and I am just way too hot to be dealing with another mannequin. Hot alert! It's fucking hot in here. I'm going to take some pictures, and then I will say bye to you downstairs so I can chat with you for a minute.
It is hours later. Did you see how hot I was up there? I really thought I was going to drop dead. I can't believe that never in my life, when I grew up in this house, we never had an air conditioner upstairs. We didn't even get our first air conditioner until I was 15, and it was just one, and it was just on the main level. We still would go upstairs to go to sleep, and I remember going to sleep with wet towels, cold wet towels. We would put them in ice cold water, wring them out, and go upstairs and put those on our bodies. I mean, I don't know. I just don't understand. I do have an air conditioner in that room that I could have turned on, but I have moved so many things, and the one outlet, this was an old house, there's only one outlet per room. So it's covered, so I couldn't plug in the air conditioner, but I will work on that. I was hot, I was tired, and I had editing issues. So it was a stressful day, and of course, I don't love my project. And please, please, I beg you, please don't tell me I'm being too hard on myself. I cannot believe how many comments I got on the cheerleader skirt. Absolutely hated. And I got so many people telling me, don't beat yourself up. You're too hard on yourself. And it makes me worried now that if I dislike something that I made, I don't know how I'm supposed to react. Because remember, I grew up thinking that I don't say anything right. And so I still feel like I'm supposed to be acting a certain way. I don't know what's wrong with hating something that I make. This was my 11th upcycle fashion. Only 2 out of 11 so far that I don't like. I think that the others I absolutely loved. It's impossible for me to like everything I make. And it makes me feel like I either should not bother uploading the video because I can't be fake and say, oh, it came out great. No, I have to say I don't like it. I don't like it. It's not what I wanted. It just didn't turn out to my liking. And I don't like it. And please, is that okay? Please? The last time I got so many comments that said, don't beat yourself up, I was like, was that like a phrase taught in school that I never learned? I stopped letting the comments go through. I wanted to be bedridden for 2 days because of that. See, these are the issues that I have with comments. Again, it has nothing to do with you guys, and I know many of you must like tiptoe on eggshells because you're petrified of what to say to me in a comment. And I'm only even telling you this because I fear I will have to stop Upcycle Fashions if I'm not allowed to say I fucking hate this piece that I made, because that's gonna happen. And I want it to be okay to hate something. When I love something, I show that I love it. So it's not that I hate everything, it's that I'm going to hate some things. And please, 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 please let that be okay to dislike something that I make. I can't like everything. I just can't. And I don't think there's anything wrong with hating something you do. It's how you learn. But I feel like if I'm supposed to be performing a certain way to the peanut gallery, or talking a certain way, or holding back how I feel about things, this isn't gonna work for me. Because this upcycle fashion stuff, it is very stressful for me. I totally enjoy it, but it is stressful and it is hard for me because I don't know at all what I'm doing. I can sew, but I'm not a clothing designer at all. So I'm very anxious to see the video that I watched, that I got inspired by to make this shirt, because I swear I loved the shirt that that woman made, and I hate mine. And ironically, this is the second shirt from Ben and Jason that, in my opinion, I have destroyed. The first one was the one that turned into the ugly cheerleader skirt that I know many of you liked, but it's not at all what I imagined. It wasn't what I was going for at all, and I really disliked it. I dislike this shirt too, not as much as the skirt. So far, that's the winner of fails for me. And when I say fail, I don't mean it was a fail as a skirt. It was a fail because I didn't accomplish what I wanted. But I worry so much about ruining the clothes you guys send me, so I'm a little bit stressed out about the whole series right now. I want to continue the series, but I need to be able to relax and know that I can be honest with you guys and not feel like there's something wrong with that. I don't know. I feel bad now if I say I hate the shirt that I made, but I do. I don't like it at all. But that doesn't mean that I didn't like or enjoy the process. It was all fun. It was all good. Hated being upstairs in the sauna. I mean, seriously, did you see how red I was? I had been up there for maybe 5 minutes, and then I came down, made a few adjustments, and I went back up there, and I was completely beet red and soaking wet. It really was that hot. I don't know what to say. I'm just going to end here because I think I've talked enough, and it's late, and I still have to do editing and uploading and all that. So once again, Ben and Jason, thank you for the shirt. I have one left. It's another one of my favorites. It's stripes. What am I gonna do? I'm petrified to use that shirt. But maybe the third one's the charm. I don't know. So I hope you at least enjoyed watching me struggle through this. And I don't think you really noticed in the video how much I was struggling, but it took me hours to record that. Hours. There are entire sequences. I mean, big, long parts that got taken out because I had to rearrange everything I said, because I was in a, you know, joking way saying what a disaster it was and how much I hated it and this isn't what I expected. You know, but I thought, I can't upload this. I will be slammed with don't beat yourself up. So I had to stop and just come up with another whole way of talking. That's the stressful part. So from now on, I'm not doing that. I'm just going to say it like I feel it, and I don't care if I come across as, I don't know, I don't understand why hating a shirt would be bad. It's not like I hate, well, I do hate people. I'm very tired. I'm just gonna say bye now. Thank you, Ben and Jason. Once again, I almost said Ben and Jerry. Bye. Bye. I gotta go. I gotta. Thank you.
I'm too tired to come up with anything witty to say on my end screen. I just hope I can sleep tonight. I only got 4.5 hours last night of broken sleep, well, this morning, and I'm tired.